Good morning, students. So the first lesson we have completed, that is the town mouse and the country mouse. So next, what you have to do is you have to learn the glossary. So the words given here, you have to learn it. Okay. Then after that, choosing the answer from the choices. So take the next page, that is page number 7. So here they are asking us to choose the correct answer. Okay, if we really listen the lesson carefully and attentively, we will be able to answer these questions. Okay, the first one: the town mouse and the country mouse are. So what are they? The town mouse and country mouse, what are they? They are friends or cousins or classmates. So you know the answer. The answer is cousins. So the country mouse and the town mouse are cousins. Next. The house of the town mouse was dash. So the house. So when you read the lesson, we can understand what is the house of the town mouse. So let's read the choices given there. First one: a field in a village, a building in a village, a kitchen cupboard in a town. So the answer is a kitchen cupboard in a town. The next one: the house of the town mouse was dash. So what is the house of the town mouse? So the house of the town mouse was. So the third one was not correct. So what was the food of the third one they have given is not right. So the house of the town mouse, second one is kitchen cupboard, and leave the third one, and next fourth one: at the end of the story, the country mouse. So at the end, after, at the completion of the story, at the end of the lesson, what happened? The country mouse, what the country mouse has done? Went back to his country, or stayed in the town, or visited the town mouse. So what is the right answer? It went back to the country and it never visited the town again. Not only the country mouse, even the town mouse also never visited each other again to other places. Next one. So true or false, this you have to find out by yourself. So I'll just read it, so you know what is the answer, what is the, it is true or false, you have to find out. The country mouse lives in a town. So where does the country mouse lives? Is it in a town? No, it is false. The town mouse feels very comfortable in the train. The town mouse, did it feel comfortable? No. So the second one is false. It was hot when the town mouse traveled to the countryside. So it was very hot when the town mouse traveled. So it is true. The town mouse liked to eat cooked food. Did the town mouse like to eat cooked food or raw food? It likes to eat the cooked food. It was not liking the raw food. So the fourth one is true. There are more lights, cars and lorries in the town than in the village. So there are more lights, cars and lorries in the town than in the village. It is true, because we don't find much lights and cars and lorries, all those vehicles, in the country. We can find all these in the town. So the fifth one is true. Next one. So read the following sentence from the lesson and tick the correct answer. He has asked me to spend a week in the countryside. So what is the meaning of countryside? So you have to find out the meaning of the underlined word. So countryside means what? A land with towns and cities, a neighboring country, a land outside towns and cities with fields and woods. So the meaning is third one, C. The town mouse packed his bags. So packed, what's the meaning of packed? Put something in a container so that it can be stored. Put clothes into a bag in preparation for a trip away from home. Put expensive things in a bag so as to keep them safe. So packing means the second one, because putting all the clothes in the bag. So let's go to the next page. The day was bright and sunny. So what is the meaning of sunny here? With a lot of bright light from the sun, with a cool wind from the east, without rain. So the right one is with a lot of bright light from the sun. So when the sun is very bright, we call it as a sunny. He nibbled at the root and the sugar cane. So the meaning of nibbled: took a large quantity of food, took a small quantity of food, showing a slight interest, took food with a great interest. So what is the meaning of nibbled? So nibbled means it is taking the food and chewing it very fast. So the right one, he took a large quantity of food, took a small quantity of food, showing a slight interest. So the second one, so nibbled means not eating interestingly. So took food with a great interest. So third one is not right. So nibbled means took a small quantity of food, showing a slight interest. Second one. The country mouse arrived in town. So the country mouse arrived. What is the meaning of arrived? Left for a place, got to a place, left to a place. So arrived means got to a place. That means just reached there. So the right answer is got to a place. So next one, fill in the blanks using appropriate phrases given below. So when you know the meanings of these words, then you will be able to fill these blanks. So let's read what is it. Ram Babu started his journey to his grandfather's village in Prakasham district. He caught a train to reach the village. The train arrived at the station. At that time, he was hungry and thirsty. He got off the train. Got off means when he came out of the train. So the first one is got off. Next. So he wanted to drink and eat something. So he dashed. So he looked around. When he wanted to eat, he looked around. So the second one is looked around. Second one is looked around. So next one. So he looked around but found nothing to eat or drink. He started walking towards his grandfather's house. On the way, he found a shop which was dash cool drinks. So when he found a shop, it was full of cool drinks. Next one. He had plenty of money. So he brought a cool drink and a piece of bread. Okay, children. So I will say once again. Ram Babu started his journey to his grandfather's village in Prakasham district. He caught a train to reach the village. The train arrived at the station. At that time, he was hungry and thirsty. As soon as he got off the train, the first one is got off the train, he wanted to drink and eat something. So he looked around. So all of you write the answer there. Looked around but found nothing to eat or drink. He started walking towards his grandfather's house. On the way, he found a shop which was full of cool drinks. He had plenty of money. So he brought a cool drink and a piece of bread. So plenty of money and he brought a cool drink and a piece of bread. Okay. First one is got off. Second one looked around. And the third one full of. Next one plenty of. Next one is plenty of. And next one a piece of. A piece of bread. Okay. So all of you complete the answers. So we shall see next compound nouns. The next one is compound noun. So before that, you have to complete this one. So first one is got off. Second one looked around. And next one full of, plenty of, and a piece of. So next let us see the compound nouns. Okay children, let us see now compound nouns. So what are the compound nouns? So children, nouns, first of all you should understand what are the nouns. So from primary section onwards, we are learning from first class onwards, we are learning what are the nouns. So noun means it's a name of a person, it's a person, thing, animal or place. Okay, noun means it's just a thing or it's a name of a place or a person, it can be. Okay, so it is the a naming word. Noun means it's a naming word, it's a name or it is a thing or it's a person, okay, or it is an animal. So now nouns, what are the compound nouns? So two nouns together, noun plus noun, noun plus noun, two nouns mixing together, it is called compound noun. Okay children, when two nouns we mix together and write as one word, that is called compound nouns. Okay children, did you understand what is the compound noun? Compound noun means two nouns writing together, it is the mixture of two nouns. Two nouns mix together and write as one word, that is called compound noun or compound nouns. Okay, I hope all of you understood. So let us see now what are the compound nouns. Now for example, they have given here, see, sugar. Sugar is a noun. Okay, what we keep in the coffee and tea, it is a sugar. And next, cane. Cane means it is a stick. Okay children, cane means a stick. Now sugar is different and cane is different, so we mix these two together and write as one word, that is sugar cane. So now it is not two words, sugar is not something, cane is not something, it is one. Now sugar cane is, all of us know what is sugar cane. Okay, mani tine cherukuni sugar cane anta. So now it is not two, we can't say sugar and cane. Now it is a mixture of two nouns, it is now one noun, that is sugar cane. So there are different kinds of compound nouns. Let us see what are they. So you have to match it. So I will tell you, birth, and this said day. So birthday, the first one is birthday. Next one, doorbell. Door plus bell together, it is doorbell. Next, firewood. Firewood, firewood. So after matching it, you have to write it in the line given here. Okay, next one, handkerchief. Next one is handkerchief. And next one, moonlight. Next, motorcycle. Sunshine, sunshine. Gateway. Okay, I'll tell once again: birthday, doorbell, firewood, handkerchief, moonlight, motorcycle, sunshine, gateway. Okay, after matching it, you write it in the line given there. Okay children, don't forget.